we'll be discussing one of the most famous and popular cruise lines we have here in the world, which is Norwegian Cruise Line. So may I call on Mr. Robin Romanes to discuss to you the first part of our presentation.
Thank you, Mr. Howard. Well, sir, so company background. So Norwegian Cruise Line is a Norwegian company operating cruise ships under Norwegian Cruise Line Holdings. So sir, history. Cruise Line was founded as Norwegian Caribbean Line in 1966 when it was started by Dan Cluster and Ted Harrison. So during that time, they only have one cruise ship ferry named Sunward, and it operated only for one season. Soon, Harrison left to form its own cruise line, which is named the Carnival Cruise Lines, while Cluster acquired more additional ships for the Caribbean service. So the Norwegian Caribbean Line pioneered many firsts in the cruise industry, like the first out-island cruise, the first combined air-sea program, which is a cruise accommodation combined with low fare cost in airlines, and they also were the first ship line to develop new ports like the Ocho in Jamaica. Also, Norwegian made headlines with the acquisition of the France, and they rebuilt it and named it as Norway. So during that time, the Norway was significantly larger than any other cruise ships, which paved the way for the giant cruise ships in today's cruise industry. So next, that ownership. Norwegian Cruise Line is a publicly traded company with 44.1% publicly listed on NASDAQ, or the National Association of Securities Dealers Automated Quotations. Also, the major companies which have stock are the stockholders of the NCL are the Apollo Global Management with 20%, Genting Group with 28%, and the TPG Capital with 7.9% as of 30th June 2014. So general location, Norwegian Cruise Line is headquarters in Miami-Dade County, Florida, United States, and it also has various satellite offices around the world. So mission and vision. The vision of the company is to be the cruise line of their choice, so which means that whatever type of cruise they will provide, they want to be the best out of it. Mission is to provide a consistent and superior cruise vacation by exceeding customer expectations and embracing their passion of innovation that delivers the value for their guests, travel partners, team members, and shareholders. So these are the various values of the company which they have passion. So every employee of the cruise line have committed hearts which drives their passion and having a mind of a winning attitude. Next is the customer centric. They always put customer first and give extra special attending to their needs. So teamwork, every employee of the company works together with a shared vision and a shared goal. Next is service, where they provide constantly good service and they aim to exceed the expectations of their guests. Integrity, they work with honesty, fairness, and accountability. And innovation, Norwegian Cruise Line is known for its innovation ideas, and because of that, their fashion, they drive innovation to the cruising industry. Health, safety, and environment, they also care to the safetiness of guests and the environment and community involvement, where they support commitment and work through good citizenship. So fleets, these are the current ships operated by the cruise line, the Norwegian Cruise Line. So they have the Norwegian Sky and Norwegian Sun, which is in the Sun class. Norwegian Sky was built in 1999 and it has the guest capacity of 2,000. 2,000 for weighing a 77,100 for tons. The destinations of Norwegian Sky is in the Bahamas and Florida and weekend cruises. Norwegian Sun destinations is Alaska, Pacific Coastal, South America, and Mexican Riviera cruises. In the Spirit class, they have the Norwegian Spirit, which was built in 1998, and it has destinations of Europe, Caribbean, Transatlantic, Bahamas, and Florida cruises. Under the Dawn class, they have the Norwegian Star and the Norwegian Dawn, which have the destinations of Europe, Transatlantic, Caribbean, Asia, Australia, Bermuda, Canada, and New England cruises. In the Jewel class, they have the Norwegian Jewel, built in 2005, which cruise destinations are in Alaska, Pacific Coastal, Mexico, Riviera, weekend cruises, and the Panama Canal. The other ships are the Norwegian Jade and Norwegian Pearl, which is under the Jewel class. They also have the Norwegian Gem under the Jewel class. Norwegian Epic, Norwegian Breakaway, Norwegian Getaway under the Breakaway class, and the Norwegian Escape and Pride of America. The Pride of America is under the Norwegian Cruise Line American Line. It is a part of the Norwegian Cruise Line Company, but it's under the American supervision, which operates in Hawaii. So future fleets, they have three upcoming fleets. The Norwegian Joy, which is aimed to start its operation on 2017. So it is a mega cruise ship, which weighs 168,800 tons. It is a breakaway class, and its home port will be China. Its target market will be the Chinese people. Other two is the Norwegian Bliss, which is targeted to run in 2018. Its home port will be in Seattle and Washington. And in 2019, there will be the Norwegian Epic II, which has yet a home port. So, outstanding characteristics of Norwegian Cruise Line is that they are notable for freestyle cruising philosophy. So, the Norwegian Cruise Line is the pioneer of freestyle cruising, which means that in freestyle cruising, there's no fixed time in dining in the activities, unlike the old-fashioned cruise line where there is an open first and second seating. In freestyle cruising, guests can enjoy whenever they want to eat on the places. They are free to explore the cruise with no fixed times. Also, the Norwegian Cruise Line is the innovator of freedom and flexibility at sea with no set dining times. And one of their unique characteristics is the haven by Norwegian. So the haven is a luxury deck. It's like a VIP area from the ship where it offers various amenities and privileges to the guests that will avail this haven.
Offers the best of the existing fleet, the variety. still the day we are here. So, the next presenter will be the group in Tazan, sir. She will present the deck plan.
So, maybe now we are curious of what this really means actually. So, I'll talk about the deck plan of the Norwegian Cruise Line. So, for the deck meeting, it is where the basketball court is included. Then, for the next deck, deck 17, they have here is the sports complex where there is the bungee jump, tarpaulin, it's one of their best activities in Norwegian Cruise Line. The next deck, we have the rooms, and this is where the swimming pool or the dripping pool is located. Then for the next step, the 15. So they have here is the fitness center where they have the gym, spa, and here also located the pool for the kids. Then for the next step, the 14, they all have the different types of room. Then also in the deck 13. So for the deck 12, they also have the different types of room, also in the deck 11. Then in the deck 10, we have the studio lounge. For the deck 9, we have the all the rooms types. Then for the deck 8, they have all the business centers and activities where the guests can have. So, next part is the staterooms. So, what are the types of the rooms inside the Norwegian Cruise Line? So, first is the keybed. So, keybed is located at the top of the ship. It features the most luxurious and it's the most expensive among all the types of rooms. So, we have 24-hour bathroom service, concierge service, and private sunbed where they can see the ocean. So, another type of room is a mini suite room. It is for the family deck. Then, it has accented with the finest touches and enough room to make memories there. So, it is suitable for family or four persons. Then, for the next room, we have the spa room. It is the healing spa suite, spa mini suite, and spa balcony. It is good for people who want to pamper and relax during their trip in the cruise. So the next type of room is balcony. So in balcony, they have a veranda where they can lounge. Then they also have stylish and sophisticated appointment access, which is